This is something which is really, really deeply rooted in our society that we don't really think twice before suggesting something because it comes free of cost. My father keeps saying, "Chamde ka zuban hai, jo bolna hai bol do," right? So I think it is very important that we don't really expect too much from anyone, for that matter. Be it colleges, be it students themselves. I think as a person from industry, and this is my personal belief and not just a belief, I practice it day in and day out, especially for my own department. I don't really hire people thinking that they would come on board with certain skills which are going to make them successful. Neither would I say that it is good to give them a virtual environment during the internship itself. What we are doing in turn is that we are making them not really get into a situation where they will have to work really hard for themselves to find some answers which are unearthed, right? So as an organization, what we say is that we are people with inquisitive minds. We want to find answers to a lot of questions which people don't even think about. And I think that is what we need to ignite in the students. At the school level or at the college level, we should give them an environment where they are able to experiment, think on their own and find solutions. Today the world is about MFL, more for less. How many organizations today would throw away money thinking that they will get good products from the colleges? They still have to invest in learning and training. Might as well go for colleges which are not really ranked very high and look for students who need some support. I have got projects where I have got people working for many years. Reason being, we hired them when they were very raw. One of the reasons why organizations go for fresher hiring is because they can find resources who are fungible, who could be, you know, molded the way the organization would want to mold them. And I think it is up to the organization to be ready to consider people who need help, who would want to get some support in terms of handholding. And I think that is something which will bridge the gap between the college and the corporate world. Thank you so much.
To add to what Majid said and also to address Madam's point, I think, no, I appreciate the point and we should certainly do something at a fundamental level, at a school level. However, now since the focus is on internships and possibly the student has already come to engineering now, so we can't go back in time and correct his upbringing. So now that has happened. But still, I still find hope through, say, movies like Three Idiots and Tare Zameen Par, that there are still workarounds to the situation, and we have practically done that. Mr. Kholkar was mentioning in his talk about this affordable agriculture labs. So we went, and I personally went and addressed the students there in these six colleges. We have this MIT, PICT, VIT, VIIT, PVG, all these colleges are there. And we told them, see, the purpose of evaluating you in the college, the purpose of the VIVA in the college is to evaluate your capabilities. Here we don't want to evaluate your capabilities. So what we are trying to give you is a three idiot kind of a environment. So you do whatever you want. The students are so excited when we address them. With rapt attention they are listening. We had conducted a workshop in Bhau Institute of COEP, and all these students from all these six colleges had come, and we didn't have place to stand in the big hall. It was a huge hall, but still there were so many students, extra students had come, they wanted to attend, and there were poster presentations. So the key is to drive out fear. And fear has to be driven out of every stakeholder, from the faculty's mind, from the student's mind, and even from the industry professional's mind. Fear is a big crippler in this whole process. So I think we need to work on an entire ecosystem. Till few years back or till recently, the only partnership between industry and academia was placements. Now they have added one more area, which is internships. So this piecemeal approach will not work. We'll have to look at it as a holistic thing. I had interacted with the ISI professor. They are encouraged to do consulting, and there are rates fixed, and they get incomes out of that. So it has to be a liberal, like in the US what it is. So it is very liberal ecosystem which allows everybody to flourish.
Correct. So I don't know what is the time, but you know,
I think we should stop
we
now.
Should stop? Okay.
So we have another panel discussion as well, and it's going very interesting.
Yeah. So, one only just concluding remark I would like to make. You know, whatever this internship which we are talking, which is mandatory, which is made by the university, this is not the only one university. There are a lot of other universities. They made it mandate since long time. It's running absolutely fine. To be honest with you, lot of even organizations also, they are looking for such internship. Okay, they are looking forward to engage students before they actually join for the employment. They are looking for such opportunities, and through this arrangement, I'm sure it will turn very positive. Thank you so much for your involvement, and you know, thanks for giving the opportunity to moderate the panel.
Thank you. So we spoke about change of mindset as well. I would request our trustee director to do the present the mementos to all the panelists, to start from Mr. Jagdish Chaudhary, from TCS, Mr. Majid Khan, Mr. Yogesh Deshpande, Mr. Prashad Gore, and Mr. Thakkar. And our panelist, Mr. Balram. And, okay. Mr. Nemani. And Mr. Nemani, I'm sorry. And I would like to invite for second panel discussion quickly to Dr. S. Mani Vasagam and Global. Mani Vasagam. Sir is here? Yeah, sorry. And as a moderator, Global Head Vehicle Engineering, Tata Technologies, as a moderator. And Mr. D'Souza, Assistant General Manager, Electrical, Isar Steel. Mr. Vardhraja, sir, please. And Mr. Ram. And then Mr. Sandeep Gokhale. And Mr. Arun. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Mr. Dhanraj Kole from Bharat Electronics. And Arun Nigwekar, sir, is there. Mr. Mani Vasagam, please, sir. Yeah. Moderator to be here. And then rest of them. Yes. And Kaushal. So the second panel discussion is on interpersonal skills required for internship. Although we have already started with, because all three panel discussions are, you know, those are supposed to be hand in hand. So we have already started with that. I would request sir to proceed with your, yeah.
This is a mic, right?
Yeah, that's a mic. You please, sir.
Let me get introduced.
Okay.
Like the previous panel, the moderator is meeting the panel members for the first time. So I was just doing a self-introduction. Madam, how much time we have? It's already
maximum
45 minutes. We'll see.
Half 25 minutes.
35 minutes.
Okay. 25 minutes.
Yeah, that's how we'll do it. Good afternoon, everybody. I think it's a very, very odd time. Crossed 1 o'clock. Some of you may be very hungry, maybe from the panel also. And the panel topic is a bit interesting. It's interpersonal skills required for internship. So we have come to the second stage with an assumption that this is in place and we all, the students are about to enter the respective organization. And as Madam rightly said, some of them are from their just completed their second semester, maybe waiting for their results, probably yes. And probably from fourth semester. And raw students, carefree world, they are entering the industry, a very, very complex world. I worked for Kirloskar, I worked for Tafe Group, working for Tata Group, I know the environment for a student, an 18-year-old student or 19-year-old student, it's a completely alien environment. So, how are they going to cope up with the situation when they enter, particularly if they enter Kirloskar kind of organization? I know very well, I spent 6 years in Kirloskars. It'll be too complex. So then I felt that this is a very, very right topic, because it's going to happen. The industries are going to get the student interns. The student interns are getting into the industries and face a big world, different world. So what skill set they are required? Then I was just going through the topic, interpersonal skills. For me, initially, interpersonal skills means what we define in our HR. He's a good guy or very poor in interpersonal. What is that? He fights with others. He's a friendly guy, gets along very well with everybody, or a fellow who fights with everybody. That was our HR dictionary word. I hope most of you agree with that one. Then I was doing a bit of research a couple of days back. Why this topic was given? Is that friendly or roughness alone is interpersonal or something beyond that? So I'm going to start with my very first question to the panelists about the same thing. Do you all think that interpersonal skills means only this friendly or rough behavior, or it's beyond that, like communication, adaptability, creativity, problem solving, all put together? Probably starting with Mr. Varadaraj. Mic, please. So that the tone can be set.
So good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone.
Interpersonal skills. So if you put the word interpersonal skills, it molds a person actually. What are the things required to a person? It may be technical, it may be personal, handling a problem and withstanding a pressure, everything put together. So these are the qualities of the person which molds to cope up with any kind of environment. Suppose, as far as internship is concerned, there should be some theme or agenda should be set from the academics actually. So when they send the people to any companies like OEM, so every cost center is a business, right? Every cost center is a business. So we need to encourage entrepreneurship actually here. So when you ask your student, he can be a first year, second year, third year. When he goes to one place actually, it may be finance, it may be manufacturer. So every cost center is a business unit. So how the raw material comes and what is the final delivery and how they manage the business. So instead of sticking to one particular agenda, suppose it's CAM programming, I want to learn CAM programming, I want to do something there. Apart from that, so what are the things that cost center is doing? So that kind of knowledge he has to take. So that will be beneficial for him to start a business maybe in future. So this kind of mindset is required to get in touch with all kind of business unit. Thank you.
Yeah, from my understanding, interpersonal skills for the students who are maybe in the second year or fourth year, or and when they are entering to the industry, the very most important thing is the communication. And the communication is not only the verbal but non-verbal also, because so speaking, writing, listening. But in case of when we are interacting with the people, he is interacting in the department or wherever he is allocated for his internship, so how he is connected with his colleagues as well as his immediate supervisor who is attending him, in terms of his posture, his body language, how he is working as a team. So all these aspects are very important, and we always only talk about his communication in English, or how he can speak, or whether he can speak in English or not, whether he can demonstrate what he wants or what he is understood in English or not. It is not the important. But all these areas are essential when he is entering. And when he is entering with the industry and interacting with the his colleagues or his department people, he get jumbles, number one. And to understand and to accustom with the situation in his section where he has allocated some work or some small project in his tune of 6 months or 3 months, his first connect is through the communication. So the importance of not only verbal, but verbal and non-verbal communication is important. It should get through the college, or maybe through the some soft skill training or something through the academia. So my thing is that, because we are suffering also, and also we are getting some inputs from these internships which were coming to us.
Namaskar. While I was sitting, I just, gone through this ICT internship policies, guidelines, and the thought came to my mind that, it's an interpersonal relationship. So they should understand the organization, and organization should understand the students and the purpose of, their coming for the internship. So I'm just, touching the very basic thing, which is, they should learn, they should read first again and again the vision, mission, and value system of the organization. The students going to the organization, so before they get into the organization for the internship, so they should learn about the organization. And the very basic thing is, what are the value system of the organization? What is their, the vision? And whether they can get aligned with the vision or the value system. So if they try to get aligned with the value system or the vision of the organization, I think it will be, it's very pleasing. Whenever they talk about the vision of the organization, it's really, the industry people feel that, yes, he is aligned with our value system or aligned with the vision. So it becomes very easy to, get aligned with the interns. And basically, what interns have to do there, it's not, expectation from the institutions, expectation from the industry. It's win-win situation. It's win-win situation for everybody, for the students, for the institution, and to the industry. Because it's, industry, the entrepreneurs, they have so many visions, so many ideas, and sometimes they don't employ people to implement those ideas. So to just get some data to implement those ideas, they can just throw that idea to the students, and might be some student get inspired, might be some student get interest in that particular idea, and they start working on it. It's about, just learning, observing the things around which they have never gone into all these areas, because theoretical knowledge, again, every day they get exposure to the theoretical knowledge. But it's about practical knowledge. It's about implementation of, application of your mind. And we never know that the students, we were talking about the rural and the, the urban students. So we never know about what student might be, rural student have more application of mind than the students came from urban areas. So it's like a starting race again. You know, we never know that who will excel in that race. Because industry is all about, you know, looking at the things. Understanding the departments. There are so many departments, manufacturing, you know, drawing preparation, R&D, testing, then, you know, some HR. So they get feel of that. And they can understand that what suits them best, what is the best interest of, you know, they can find out there. And it's purpose, you know, we always say that, know your purpose, what is the purpose of coming here on the earth, or what is the purpose of doing something else. So it's, you cannot find a purpose all of a sudden. But, you know, understanding so many things, you know, they can get feel that, yeah, this is, I'm very comfortable with this. Or I can do something better in this. So they can take the challenge, they can do something about it. And it's, as I said, it's a win-win situation for the industry, students, and the institution. Because the students, when students are happy, institutions are happy. Otherwise, they will always complain, ki, I'm not getting this thing, I'm not getting that thing, because they will be always comparing other students who are in the other industry.
Sir, I would like to tell you now. We'll cover it up.
Hello. In my opinion, the internship is the first step the students get exposed to the industry. And we get the students under this category in three, four titles. That is internship, summer training, industrial training, vocational training. I mean, the meaning of the four is the same. And generally, it is done between second year to third year. The name itself says it's a training. So expecting from the students that he will participate in the team for problem solving and delivering, I think it is a little more higher. So what we do when they come for internship, we attach them with our engineers. Expose them what the people are working, the instruments, how do they look like. So that when they go back to the college, and when the concepts are understood, how to measure, I'm electronics, so I'll refer electronics, how to measure voltage, how to measure current, they understand more when they go learn in third years. So, in my opinion, what minimum qualities or minimum requirement from the students is, when it's given, he goes to industry, first of all, he should be very punctual. There should be will to learn and the curiosity to ask the questions. I think this basic soft skill and some basic knowledge what is going to get exposed. Suppose we say oscilloscopes. He should know what minimum oscilloscope. He wouldn't have handled. But what does oscilloscope means? I think these are the minimum skills the students should have when he's given for the internship. That's what our industry does. That is what my opinion is about.
Thank you. So we are all agreeing that it is not just friendly or roughness is the interpersonal skill. It's beyond that. Okay. So with that understanding, I'll ask the next question. Probably I'll ask two or three questions and then I'll leave it open to the participants. How important you all think that adaptability is a very important skill for the interns to get into and survive? In those 2 weeks or 4 weeks or professor suggested 6 months project equivalent of that one. Yeah,
adaptability is a major thing actually, without which it's not possible to learn anything. Because when your intern is coming to a company, everyone will encourage him actually. So that is a plus point for him actually, to speak with from the operator to the general manager. If it's an intern, there's a lot of interest in the industry. So how good the existing population of students is, how good they are in technical aspects. So everyone wants to interact with them. So that is a very good platform for him to make it adaptable. And the person should be very outspoken actually. So general managers come actually, what will think if you speak to him? So such kind of hesitance should not be there actually. So adaptability is a very plus point and is always available in the industries.
Yes.
I will give one example. In our company, we take around 10 to 12 internships from various industries, various academic colleges, local or outside, or maybe from Nagpur College. Students comes here with some understanding what they have to do, a project, maybe some some senior inputs from their senior students or something. And within a few days of some working and understanding, which we give the project to them or some work in sections. So we think that all are not getting tuned to the what we have given the work. Then we interviewed them. We asked them with what understanding you came, because the inputs are very much, because they may have some friends into some TCS or some software industry or some automotive industry, ours in engineering industry. So the type of job or type of work they get from our side from their internship, they may not be suitable. But we have to tell, why this is the work for this 4 weeks or 6 weeks or 2 months. It is not your final, you have to get tuned with what is the project given to you. So this type of thinking which the students have, so first of all, before putting them to the industry for this internship, because it will be not selective type of work they will get, what they want or what they have in their mind, or maybe different friends in other industries they are working with some internship. So some things come to their mind something differently. So the adaptability of work which the industry will give, or maybe some section will give, or so it is going to be very different. So when the students are coming from the college, academia, to the different industries, so that thought, what is expected by the institution or by the academia as per the curriculum, and what the work they will get into the industry, in different industry, maybe something different. So that should be the connect when they will come to the college, from college to the industry. So that way the adaptability in my way will be the useful, and it will be useful that those students what to learn and how they will spend effective time into that 4 to 6 months or maybe the 3 months.
Yes, thank you. My perspective for adaptability is, see, we do many things, we learn many things with giving so much of attention, pressure, forcibly we try to learn the things. And when we have acquired lot of knowledge, lot of theoretical knowledge, and we are always curious to know what is there, or what they have in their mind, I have to do this project, or I have, I should get this environment. See, students, they don't have any option. They have to adapt the, whatever it is being offered by the organization, the industry. It is very, very important for their future life also. You know, how they learn with so much of pressure or so much of this thing, putting their every efforts. So when they go to some other area to learn something, so they have to de-learn that, and it's also, it becomes a very tedious or very hectic process. So I think that skill they should have, so that they can, wherever they go, it's not about the institution and from institutions to the industry for internship, wherever they work in their life in the future. So they have to have that quality of adaptability.
Thank you, sir. Sir, can we take few questions from audience? Yeah. We are getting late. So one or two questions, please, if you can. Yeah.
Actually, I don't have a question, but I have, as the topic is about skill, I want to just link it to some of the situations which we come across in the organization about vulnerability of the students or the coming into the organization, and they do not really stick to their strengths, what they are actually coming from, and that's what we realize. The maximum attrition in the organization happens in the first 5 years, and then they just hop from one job to another job. So one skill I would like to actually bring it here is the goal-based learning. Like, do they have really goal in their life which they are chasing for? And the answer definitely is no, and not only for the students or the new joiners in the organization, even for the senior most employees in the organization, many of them do not have their life goals. So I would like to really think about that, how do we bring this understanding about what is they would like to achieve in their life. That doesn't miss at the end of their career, but let's say next one month, one year, what is their target they should be achieving for. Why I say this is very, very important. If you think about subject matter expertise, it takes almost 20,000 hours of work experience if you want to consider somebody to be expert into that area. So if the students are just hopping from one job to another job, how can we develop experts in the organization whom we are expecting to solve the problems? So that is what I feel, that skill development through goal-based and strength-based learning is one of the area I would like to really think and then kind of educate students that how do they think from their life perspective. And I'm very, very sure that if some of them adopt this mentality, the long-term career success is going to be a guaranteed. If you think about many successful employees, successful businessmen, successful professors, they have been in their firms, in their areas for many, many years, right? And that is what I would like to think about. How do we make this habit to the employees, habit to the students about skill base?
Yeah, very good afternoon, sir. I'm GVN Raji from Hyderabad. I'm director, Way to Transform Private Limited. It's wonderful to note that do they require interpersonal relations, especially people who get into this internship? Yes. First of all, we need to give them confidence to connect with the people. Like corporate to or college to corporate, we need to give them confidence to connect with people. Before we talk to them or before any institution sends them to the organization, well ahead, at least 6 months before, these people have to give them that which kind of industry you are entering into, what kind of situation you would be facing, because it's a real-time situations where they would be interacting with the immediate boss or maybe the guide or the mentor who is there. So it's a responsibility of the institution to give them before sending them to the internship. That's what's my feeling. And this interpersonal relations relates to emotional skills. So as we have been discussing about, the most important life skill is to understand people, understand their emotions, and while approaching to the boss or while approaching their head of the department, one has to understand that what I'm going to speak, do I have, when I'm speaking to them, do I have enough knowledge or do I have better write the question before they ask, and rather than wasting the time of the people. So interpersonal relationships all about understanding and connecting to the people. So it's very, very important. Second home of the student is only the college. So the teachers have to understand this well in advance, and these people, the teachers have to take a lot of interest in this to really give them, to update them about interpersonal relationships, because a lot of institutions, they keep talking about it, but when we send our own people, if they don't have, then it's a big communication gap. Thank you.
Yeah, well taken. Somebody, the last row.
My colleague correctly pointed out that the intern should know about their colleagues, who are the boss, who is the subordinate. My request is, when the student is going to spend 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 5 weeks, hierarchy of the organization, at least related to that particular shop, should be disclosed to the student or to the institute. Then only the interperson relations are possible. When I did my training in telco at that time, Tata Motor was called telco. At that time also, I faced the same difficulty. Mm-hmm. I was knowing only my boss and no other colleagues. Even the electrician or technician, what are his duties, responsibility, I was not knowing. If the HR spent 1 day or 1 hour with the student, then that will be the great advantage.
Right, yeah. We agree on that. Yeah. Yeah. Samir, in the last row.
I'm Ajay, I'm from Beckhoff Automation. I just want to ask the panelists and also the institute, before sending, do you have any benchmarking what he should be after this internship program has been completed? Do you have any evaluation model developed?
Sir, yes. The complete evaluation model is ready. How the students goes, what kind of report they have to do. When we take orientation program, we'll show you this is our process, how the activity flow is, and with the rubrics as well. So one day orientation, when we talk about, we tell students that they need to be, how they have to behave, do's, don'ts, right from your their CV preparation, to whom to apply. We have received, to be very frank, we have received call from companies that students are approaching so and so people, but they need to approach, you know, a proper channel. So proper channel, how, where to apply, how to apply. So all kind of orientation we do. If you go through these guidelines again, they have also given, like student would apply for three companies. The one company would be finalized wherever. How would be a joining process? How would be a evaluation process? What would be the frequency of evaluation? What would be a parameter? Student 360 degree feedback, teacher, industry, student, and finally grading. What would be the criteria for grading? If there are incidences, we have a policy being the autonomous institution, many a times like Godrej, Mercedes in Pune. So they ask us, the student is performing very well, we want to extend the internship. So what should be the policy? Because academics goes by credits. So we have 160 or 180 credits. Now students will not be studying 5 subjects. So what would be the option? Whether the industry would be teaching, evaluating on the subjects which he has not learned. Because tomorrow, ultimately, his degree would be his blanket permission for, you know, his 30, 35 years of his career, and not only the internship. So all that has been summarized in the AICT policy, and every institution is free to come up with their own, being autonomous. However, this autonomy is not to the affiliated colleges, so they need to go with the standard document which is being affiliated university, which is being prepared by the university. But we have our own model, so we'll share that as well. Next question, please. Last question, I guess.